Hello students, in the previous video you have seen the some uses of important prepositions. In the same reference, in this particular video I am going to discuss another important uses of prepositions, and in the same reference I am going to tell you a very important topic of preposition, and that is over. The ninth preposition is over, and it is the use of this preposition is it gives the sense of covering, have that, or spread over. The use of the preposition over gives the sense of covering, have that, or spread over. You have to consider the underlying words covering, higher than, and spread over. And in this reference, the surface of both the objects may or may not be in contact. For the example, to know more about this, you have to see some more examples. And here is the first example, that is the birds are flying over the tree. The birds are flying over the tree. Here the underlined word over is a preposition which is used to show the sense of covering, higher than, or spread over. And there is no surface contact between the objects, birds and the tree. So we can say that the over is the preposition which gives the sense of covering, higher than, or spread over. And in this reference, the surface of both the objects may or may not be in the contact. And here is the same reference, the second example, and that is there is a breeze over the river. There is a breeze over the river. Here the underlined word over is a preposition which is used to show the sense of covering, higher than, or spread over. And there is no surface contact between the two objects, breeze and the river. So this is the example related to the same preposition and its detail. And here is the next preposition, that is below. Below is the preposition and it gives the sense of lower than. Below is the preposition which is used in English grammar, gives us the sense of lower than. And in this reference, the surface of both the objects are not in the contact. It gives the sense of lower than, and the surface of both the objects are not in the contact. Here is the example. For the example, the sun sank below the horizon. Here the underlined word below is the preposition which is used to show the sense of lower than, and there is no contact between the objects, the sun and the horizon. So we can say that below is the preposition which gives us the sense of lower than, and in this reference the surface of both the objects are not in contact. And in the same reference, here is the second example, and that is the temperature is 10 degrees below zero. The temperature is 10 degrees below zero. Here the underlined word below is the preposition which is used to show the sense of lower than, and there is no surface contact between the objects, the temperature and the degrees. So we can say that below gives us the sense of lower than, and there is no surface contact between the two objects in the same reference. So this is the use and the example of below. In the same reference, here is the next preposition, and that is under. So what is the use of under? To know more about it, you have to see the detail about the preposition under, and that is under gives the sense of vertically below that. Under gives the sense of vertically below or exactly lower than. And the surface of both the objects may or may not be. You have to consider the underlying words. May or may not be in contact. In the same reference, the surface of both the objects may or may not be in the contact, and it shows the sense of vertically below or exactly lower than. For the example, here is an example, and that is there is something under the bed. There is something under the bed. Here the underlined word under, it is used to show the sense of vertically below. Vertically below, and there is no contact between the objects. And here is the second example, and that is he wore a shirt under his sweater. He wore a shirt under his sweater. Here the underlined word under also shows the sense of vertically below or exactly lower than, and there is a surface contact between the sweater and the shirt. So we can say that under is a preposition which gives us the sense of vertically below or exactly lower than, and in the same reference there is the surface contact may or may not be appear in the same reference. And here is the example related to the same topic. And the next important preposition is in front of. In front of, and the use of the same preposition is, here is it, it gives the sense of facing something. In front of is a preposition which gives us the sense of facing something. For the example, she was standing in front of the gate. She was standing in front of the gate. And as a kind of your information, students, let I tell you that before is also a preposition which is used to show the sense of facing something, and it is used mostly in the reference of the living things. And in front of is also a preposition which is used to show the sense of facing something, and mostly it is used in the reference of the non-living things. Here's the gate. Gate is the non-living thing, so we use in front of. So we can say that in front of is a preposition in English grammar that is used to give the sense of facing something, such as she was standing in front of the gate. Here the underlined word in front of is the preposition which is used to show the facing of something. So you have to watch it very carefully. And here is the same reference. The next preposition is behind. The next preposition, number 13, is behind. And the correct use of the particular preposition is, here is the detail about it, and it gives the opposite sense of facing something. Here is the opposite sense. In front of gives us the sense of facing something, and behind is the preposition which gives us the sense of opposite sense of facing something. You have to consider the underlying words. Opposite sense of facing something. For the example, who is the girl standing behind the behind Rocky? Who is the girl standing behind Rocky? Here the underlying word behind. It is used to show the sense of. It is used to show the opposite sense of facing something. So we can say that behind is the preposition which gives us the sense, or which gives us the opposite sense of facing something. In the same way, here is the second example, and that is the sun disappeared behind the clouds. The sun disappeared behind the clouds. Here the underlying word behind is the preposition which gives the opposite sense of facing something in the sentence. So this is also a very important preposition, and you have to watch the detail about it and related examples also. And here is the next example, next preposition, and that is very important one. And the preposition is beside. Beside means by the side of. Beside means by the side of, and the same preposition gives the sense of just next to. You have to consider the underlying words just next to. Just next to means by the side of. Beside is the preposition which gives us the sense of just next to. For the example, come and sit beside me. Come and sit beside me. So here the underlined word beside is the preposition which gives us the sense of by the side of or the just next to. And here is the next preposition, that is near. What is the correct use of near? And here is the detail about it. And the detail is, it gives the sense of close by. Near is the preposition in English grammar that gives us the sense of close by. For the example, the shop is near the road. The shop is near the road. Here in the particular sentence, the underlying word near is a preposition which gives us the sense of close by, that the shop is close by the road. The shop is close by the road. So we can say that near is the preposition which gives us the sense of close by. And this is the sense. And here is the next preposition, and that is very important one. And the preposition is opposite to. So what is the correct use of opposite to? And here is the detail about it. And the detail is, it gives the sense of the other side. Opposite to means the sense. It gives the sense of the other side. For the example, the new showroom that he has put up is opposite to the central mall. The new showroom that he has put up is opposite to the central mall. Here the underlying words opposite to is a preposition which gives us the sense of the other side. Which gives us the sense of other side. You have to consider the underlying words. The sense of other side is equal to opposite to. And the next preposition is by. And here is the detail about the same preposition. And the detail is, it is used to indicate the sense of next to. By gives us the sense of next to. You have to consider the underlying word next to. By means next to. For the example, there is a switchboard by the road. There is a switchboard by the door. Here the underlying word by, it is used to show the sense that the switchboard is just next to the door. Here in the particular sentence, the underlying preposition by is used to show the sense that the switchboard is just next to the door. So we can say that by is a preposition which is used to indicate the sense of next to. And here is the second example related to the same expression, and that is, my study table is by my bed. My study table is by my bed. Here the underlying preposition by is a word, is a preposition which is used to show the sense that the table is just next to the bed. So we can say that the preposition by always gives us the sense of next to. And here is the next preposition, and that is from. Very important preposition, that is from. And you have to know the correct detail about the same preposition, and the detail is, it is used with the point of departure, from. From is the preposition which is used to show the sense of departure, point of departure. You have to consider the underlying words, point of departure. For the example, he has already gone from the village. He has already gone from the village. Here in the particular sentence, the underlying word gone is a preposition which is used to show the sense, or which is used the point of departure in the sentence. So we can say that from is a preposition in English grammar which gives us the sense of point of departure. These are the some important prepositions and their uses and the related yourself. And this is the fourth and the last part of the same topic, preposition. You have to watch it very carefully. And that's entire. Thank you very much.